and just sort of to put a little bit of meat on the bones, Lord Porter, who's the chair of the LGA, is actually a Tory minister MP.
Councillor.
And he is the one who's pushing the government more and more and more for more funding for looked after children. They reckon in the next couple of years there's going to be a gap of £2 billion. £2 billion gap in what we need to look after our most vulnerable children. 75% of genetics, 75% of councils around the country are having to put extra money into looking after their most vulnerable children. But here in the world, we've stepped up to the plate, we've done it. We want to make sure that the voice of children goes across everything that we do. Every single thing that we do, whether it be George for housing, whether it be the environment, whether it be community, the voice of the child has to be heard. It takes one family to take it to give birth to a child. It takes the streets and a community to help bring that child up. We're all corporate parents, and I am absolutely delighted that we found the money to make sure that our children's services is going to improve, and not just improve, it's going to be one of the best in the country for the children, for children to grow up on the world and to have life chances on the world. So I thank all my cabinet members who have had to take a hit to provide this money. We've all had to say, okay, I'll take slightly less money to make sure that we've got money for children's services. Everybody around this table, everybody within this council, all our staff, all the members are totally dedicated to make sure that we provide the best we can for children's services. So thank you, Phil, thank you, Cabinet, for support the children.
Thanks, Bunny. Okay, I've got Stuart, and then Matthew, and then Angie. Stuart.
Thanks, Phil. I certainly am an advocate for a new member of Labour, as it didn't come to politics to be flag of press with people and put charges on. Various awards now for our environmental services, and I think the world's actually a fantastic, beautiful place. We've got more green flags in our country parks than anywhere else. Our beaches are fantastic, and in the context of £61 million we've had to find, and of course the £20 million investment in children's services, whilst entirely regrettable, I think the modest proposed charges for the coastal locations. It's probably the best we could do. It's not something I want to do. But certainly want to be introducing new charges. Certainly don't want to put the council tax up. To keep council tax as an aggressive form of taxation. Whereby it's the value of property that's taken into account on your income. And when you look at the tax breaks that have been given to the super rich and these other companies, at the same time the government's forced their responsibilities onto low earners, I think that's absolutely important, and I think that gives example illustration of the agenda of this government. I think in this budget as well, so I welcome the investments in our children's service, also welcome the investments in our infrastructure, particularly our streetlight stop, which is obviously more difficult as time goes by to maintain and could be in order. Also, investments in our staff. I think for far too long, the public sector colleagues have been the brunt of austerity policies. I think the 3% will bring them in line, but as we all know, this is pay has not been keeping with inflation for a number of years now. Stop some of the people who are the pots of ordinary people who actually aren't spending the benefits of the economy.
Thank you, Stuart. Okay, Matthew.
Thank you, Phil. I commend the budget as well. I think it's really important that we recognise the £60 billion we're looking to save in this financial year. It doesn't sit in isolation. There's been many, many millions we've been saving before now, and I don't think any of us are foolish enough to think that the pain stops now. I think next year, the year after, and for as long as we have a Tory government, that pain will continue. And it's obviously the responsibility of this administration to ensure that the most vulnerable people are protected. And I think our investment in children's services is attempting that. And I'm I'm pleased that when I think at councils across the country clearly are at breaking point, and some even beyond that moment now, and I think we're all going towards that destination, which needs to change. We need to change tact at the very top level to stop that from happening. I'm pleased that we've still managed to keep this budget distinctly Labour. I think that our values of protecting people, I think the money we're putting into domestic abuse, I thought was really important. I think the fair pay of the people that work here and the investment, as mentioned, in social care at a time when nationally that's in crisis are really important things that don't happen if the people around this table aren't around this table. I wanted to commend that, but I think it's really important also that we thank not just our staff, but our residents as well. Many, many thousands have formally got in touch through the process, but I know that all of the Cabinet who go out in their communities each and every day are hearing comments and concerns and hopefully sometimes praise like the award that Phil mentioned about the work that does go on here. And ultimately, it's the people of Wirral that respond to our requests and they work with us. I think they're getting it. I think they're getting that this is an onslaught from central government that doesn't stop until we change government. And I'd be really happy to achieve that if there is a leadership announcement in the Tory party soon. Let's bring it on and let's have an election and let's change this government leader. I think we live in an incredible place on the world and I think it's made brilliant by its residents. And I want to thank those people that do all the work to keep our communities really positive, and I think they work tremendously with us on our budget to put forward, so I commend the budget.
Thanks, Matthew. Okay, Angie.
In the face of £250 million worth of cuts since 2010, it's been vital that we've been able to responsibly use the capital receipts that we've generated since the 1st of April 2016 to fund this local authority's extensive transformation programme. This has enabled us to innovate and work on a range of different programmes in relation to children's services that you spoke about, learning, health and social care integration, our digital strategy, our growth and strategic regeneration framework, as well as a number of other customer experience and reform programmes. In the face of the savage cuts from the Tory government, we welcome the extension of the scheme to use capital receipts until March 22, and we fully endorse the work that our transformation team are doing along with staff throughout the council and also the board.
Okay. Thanks, Angie. And you're right to highlight the important work that we're doing on new delivery models, because we need to ensure that we bring new income streams into the council, we work more smartly because of the funding, the cliff face that we're facing. And that work is essential as well as the work that we do to generate more income into the party. So my thanks to the team that involved in that. Chris.
Thank you, Phil. For my part, I'd just like to thank everybody, actually, who works in adult social care and all our health organisations in Wirral for the hard work they're delivering and dealing with unprecedented increased demand, both in hospital and in the community. I'm really pleased that priority has been given for the most vulnerable in our budget. But until adequate funding is given by the government to enable us to provide the quality of care we would like to, we are struggling.
Yeah, and it was, I echo that. I was just amazed that the Chancellor in his autumn statement didn't even mention the social care crisis last autumn. That was just beggars belief, really. How out of touch that they are with the needs of those people. Okay, well, thanks, colleagues, for all your contributions. I think we'll move now to the recommendations. So, item six now, the revenue budget for council tax levels for 18-19. So the resolution I've circulated has got an additional recommendation in, which is item see around the 3% pay award for our staff. So I'm looking to, my learned colleagues are right here to keep on straight now. So we'll take a vote on those recommendations.
Can we do a straight block?
Can we do a whole straight block? Is that okay? Okay, great. All the recommendations on six. Right, including school budget. Okay, great. Well, okay, I'll formally move all of those recommendations. Seconded by George. Can I see all those in favour? Okay, that's unanimous. Thank you very much. So that's all the issues to do with item 6 on the budget? Yes? I've not been informed of any other business?
Treasury
management report. Sorry, I do apologise. So that's 6B, Jeanette.
Yes.
Are you going to say a few words?
I will make it very brief, given that
we're all fairly
similar.
Sorry,
I'll just quickly say the Authority Treasury Management activities underpinned by CIPA's Code of Practice on Treasury Management, which requires the production of annual prudential indicators and the Treasury Management Strategy Statements on ID financing and investment activity. This report fulfills the Authority's legal obligation under the Local Government Act 2003 to have regard to both the CIPA Code and the Department of Communities and Local Government investment guidance. Rural Council continues to use its treasury management function proactively for the benefit of Wirral. The revenue monitoring report elsewhere on the agenda forecast savings of £6.4 million in 2017-18, with further significant savings in treasury management activities in 2018-19, contributing to closing our budget gap. The treasury management strategy has complied with expert independent support from our treasury management advisors. Strategy clearly lays out our policies in respect of borrowing and investments. It also enables the Council to have the flexibility to continue its forward journey in increasingly commercial environments, earning income and reducing costs to support and services while protecting the Council's resources. I just ask that we have this more recommendations that are with them.
Okay, they agreed?
Thank
you. Okay, so we've dealt with now all the budget recommendations. They agreed unanimously. Sorry, we've now dealt with all the budget recommendations. They would agree unanimously. They will now go on to Budget Council on the 5th of March. And obviously we'll await any amendments from the opposition. Look forward to receiving that. So I think that concludes the business for this morning. Can I thank everybody for their attendance and formally close the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you.